My name is Seth Oyama from Tokyo University, Japan. Today, I'd like to talk about quantitative measurement of pulse ultrasound pressure field using optical phase contrast. In recent years, the research and development of ultrasound application in medicine has progressed, especially for diagnostics and therapeutic purpose. For example, there is ultrasound diagnosis and HIFU treatment. Such medical ultrasound applications as ultrasound probe and array transducer have various exposure sequences. Judging from this situation, in order to confirm the safety of the ultrasound application, various ultrasound pressure fields should be measured. So we believe that establishment of fast and accurate measurement of ultrasound pressure field is needed. Next, let me explain the measurement method of ultrasound field. The conventional way to measure the ultrasound field is using hydrophone method. The advantage of hydrophone method is to measure quantitatively. However, hydrophone method might disturb ultrasound field and takes a very long measurement time. In contrast, another alternative method that caught our attention is optical method. In optical method, we let the collimated light pass through the ultrasound field and acquire the image by camera. The acquired image gives you the brightness distribution. Optical method might not disturb ultrasound field and requires a short measurement time. However, the disadvantage of the optical method is to measure qualitatively. Based on the advantage and disadvantage, our motivation is to apply the optical method and combine it with CT algorithm to quantitatively measure the ultrasound field. The objective in this study is to optically measure pulse ultrasound pressure field. Pulse ultrasound requires wide frequency band and high sensitivity. So, improvement of the SNR of the acquired images is needed. The optical method for ultrasound field can be classified to two categories. One is shallow graph method. The other is phase contrast method. For pulse ultrasound pressure field in this study, phase contrast method has high SNR. So, we selected phase contrast method for measurement of pulse ultrasound field. Next, let me explain the modulation of optical phase. Ultrasound is longitudinal waves. So, when it propagates through the water, varied density of water molecule mediums is formed. When the collimated light passes through this medium, the optical phase modulation corresponds to the density of gradient. When the ultrasound field is assumed as a phase object, the phase modulation can be calculated as this equation. For this equation, the phase modulation is proportional to an integral value of the pressure field. So, if we can measure the phase modulation by using optical phase contrast method, ultrasound pressure field can be reconstructed by CT algorithm. Next, let me explain the theory of phase contrast method. I will address it as PC method. First, theory of PC method can be regarded as theory of phase contrast microscopy. This figure shows a part of PC method setup. The convex lens used here forms special Fourier spectrum of outer sample field on its focal plane. The special spectrum consists of DC spectrum and diffracted light spectrum. DC spectrum is unobstructed by ultrasound field, and diffracted light spectrum receives phase modulation by ultrasound field. Furthermore, we can express this spectrum in unit circle as this. Now, theory of PC method is to advance the phase of DC spectrum and get the interference between two spectra and measure the phase modulation from its intensity. Next, let me explain the phase plate used in PC method. Phase plate was made of silica glass. Two small columns with different height were etched onto its surface to advance DC spectrum phase by pi over 2 or 3 pi over 2. So, the phase plate is set up at the convex lens focal plane like this, so that only DC spectrum could pass through to advance the phase. Next, I will explain columns of phase plate. We selected the theoretical equation of phase contrast method by the intensity of measured outer sound. In previous study, phase plate with one column was used. The theoretical equation of this phase modulation can be derived as this equation. Then we can use this equation for especially low intensity ultrasound. On the other hand, in this study, phase plate with two columns was used. This theoretical equation can be derived as this equation of arc sine. We can use this equation for both moderate and high intensity ultrasound. In this study, the phase plate with two columns was tested for the moderate intensity. Next, this experiment setup is shown in this figure. First experiment step is to measure DOF of camera lens and place the transducer at the center. Second, we set up phase plate and obtain 150 images with and without ultrasound exposures respectively. Finally, we determined phase modulation by PC method and applied a filter in special frequency domain to the modulated phase distribution. Next, I will explain a filter in special frequency domain to improve SNR of the modulated optical phase distribution. In the special frequency domain, a bandpass filter combining rectangular and Gauss windows like this was applied to phase distribution. Then the filter was carefully turned by taking the bandwidth of the ultrasonic path into account. Next, now, let me show the result of path ultrasound pressure field reconstructed by CT algorithm. This figure shows the reconstructed path ultrasound pressure field of the focal zone. And this figure shows the cross-sectional waveforms of path ultrasound pressure field without bound pass filter and without bound pass filter in the axial direction. In comparison with the waveforms without bound pass filter, the SNR or pulse ultrasound pressure field in this study was successfully improved. Next, we compared the cross-sectional waveforms of the pulse ultrasound pressure field focused on in the axial and lateral direction between optical method and hydrophone. This figure shows the waveforms in the axial direction and lateral direction. As you can see, good agreement is clearly seen for the waveforms in the both directions. For absolute peak pressure, the difference between two methods was about 15%. So this result agreed well. Finally, let me explain the comparison of measurement time between two methods. This table shows measurement time of two methods. For agglution time, the optical measurement for 3D space took approximately 3 minutes, while hydrophone measurement for a plane took more than 60 hours. So the proposed optical measurement time was shorter by orders of magnitude. In conclusion, we reconstructed a pulse ultrasound pressure field from the acquired optical intensity images by using optical phase contrast method. The result of the proposed method provides good agreement with that of hydrophone method. While the measurement time of the proposed method was shorter by orders of magnitude. Further study is needed for the measurement of focused ultrasound field at high intensity. Thank you for your attention.